Hey guys, welcome back to Fallout 4. Today we are going to be meeting up with the Brotherhood of Steel. Unfortunately, I lost the clip of me meeting the female knight that's guarding Logan International Airport. But all she says is basically, I go up there and I say, "Oh, can I get up on that ship? Blah, blah, blah." And then she's like, "Well, if you want to join us, you can meet up with Dance. He's at the police station downtown." So that's where we're headed right now. Right now we're in College Square, and the police station is right around the corner. Apparently all of downtown has been infested by ghouls. So it's kind of like a little zombie shooter here. Hopefully Dance sees our combat skills and says, "All right, you're cool," and lets us join the Brotherhood of Steel. But I'm sure we're gonna have to jump through a lot of hoops. But I did run into, I found a dead Brotherhood of Steel. I think Knight or Paladin or something. In I think the National Guard fort that wasn't not too far from where we are right now. So I'm actually wearing her Brotherhood of Steel suit and armor, because her armor has the Brotherhood of Steel logo on it. And I do have her dog tags in my inventory too, so hopefully they don't notice that I'm pretending to be somebody else. But actually, you know, doesn't even come up. But yeah, so hopefully everything goes well with the Brotherhood of Steel. We get some cool power armor. I hope, because they kind of give us power armor in the beginning of the game, which usually was a thing that you would get as being part of the Brotherhood of Steel. So I wonder what they got to give you something crazy for actually joining the Brotherhood of Steel. So let's try to impress these guys. And hopefully they won't die and we'll lose whatever we have to do.
Now what they get to. Hi.
We appreciate the assistance, civilian, but what's your business here?
Before I answer, will you tell me who you are?
In due time. If you want to remain in our compound, I suggest you answer my question first.
A Brotherhood soldier pointed me this way. I might be interested in joining up.
Interested in recruitment, huh? Well, let me ask you a few questions. Are you from a local settlement?
Do all these questions really matter? After all, I help you fight those ferals.
You make a fair point. If I appear suspicious, it's because our mission here has been difficult. Since the moment we arrived in the Commonwealth, we've been constantly under fire. If you want to continue pitching in, we could use an extra gun on our side.
I want to help, but I don't like the secrecy. Who are you, really?
You owe us that much.
Very well. I'm Paladin Dance, Brotherhood of Steel. Over there is Scribe Halen and Knight Reese. I've been trying to send a distress call to our vessel at Boston International Airport, but the signal's too weak to reach them.
Sir, if I may...
Proceed, Halen.
I've modified the radio tower on the roof of the police station, but I'm afraid it just isn't enough. What we need is something that will boost the signal.
Our target is ArcJet Systems, and it contains the technology we need, the deep-range transmitter. We infiltrate the facility, secure the transmitter, and bring it back here. So what do you say? You willing to lend the Brotherhood of Steel a hand?
If I do this, will I become one of you?
That all depends on your performance in the field, civilian. Let's just call it what it is, a test of your abilities. So are you in? Or not?
No time to waste. Let's get moving.
Outstanding. Halen, take Reese inside and bind his wounds.
Yes, sir.
Reese, once you're on your feet, I want you to make certain the perimeter is secure.
I'm on it.
All right, civilian. It's time to prove your worth. Head into the police station and resupply yourself. Then let me know when you're ready to begin. Let's move out, people.
All right, big guy. Let's go.
Yeah, I'm coming.
So you gonna patch me up or what?
I don't know. Your prognosis looks pretty grim. Might be more humane to just take you out back and shoot you.
You're all heart, Doc.
Just quit squirming so I can get these bandages on.
Yeah, so just cut out a lot of looting. If you're new to my channel or new to watching my Fallout videos, I loot pretty much everything and then I sort it out later. Kind of like kill them all, let God sort them out. I loot it all and then I sort it out later. But yeah, I cut out most of that. So I pretty much just looted this whole police station, every little nook and corner and cranny. And I'm going to do a little bit more looting after we hack this computer. Which is a tip, you know, instead of locking yourself out, just step away from the computer and try again. The hacking can be a little tricky. You know, it is pretty simple, just, you know, trying to match up letters. But if you're not really in the mood for thinking, or matching. You can just brute force it and do the first couple and then back away and then try again and back away and try again. Because they do get more complicated. Later on, obviously, you know, in the harder difficulty harder terminals. But yeah, I'm just gonna keep trying. And another thing too, if you haven't been watching my episodes, I don't read these out loud, so just I'm gonna pop them up. You pause it, read it at your own speed, and then I'm gonna go to the next one. Just open it up. You can pause the video, read it at your own speed, and then, you know, because I just skim them for any information, and if there's any important information, my map will get updated, like I think it just did now. So you don't really need to read it to get all the information. But sometimes there is, you know, like, oh, we hid something over here, and I don't think that'll add to like your miscellaneous quest, but it might, like one of the first ones that you encounter at the Red Rocket gas station. They mention how they hid something, you know, in like a cave or something, and it's just around the corner underneath the gas station, and there's some good stuff in there, along with some, like, I think rad roaches. But other than that, if there's any passwords or, you know, someone left at the fort or blah blah blah, your map will get updated, or the password will automatically be put into your Pip-Boy, so you don't need to remember or read anything. But, you know, if you want to be into the story and the lore and all of that of Fallout, obviously read it. There's a lot of good stuff in it, and there is a lot of funny stuff most of the time. Like, for instance, one of the passwords that you have to get from a terminal, you know, it's one of those classic emails, like, letting everybody know, we're changing the password today, so the new password for today is blah blah blah, because, let's say Eric messed around and told some girlfriend while he was sleeping and while he was drunk, so we have to change the password today, so now it's 1234 instead of 1235, or, you know, Fallout makes at least it fun, and not just, like, stupid video gamey kind of thing. But, you know, it's basically like every video game, if there's a password you have to find, it's usually just an email like, hey, we're changing our passwords. Here's the new password. It's kind of stupid because who sends emails like that? Although I guess I've never been in a quote-unquote office job. So maybe people do that. Maybe people in offices actually send emails for the new passwords. But usually it's, I would think it'd be word of mouth, not sending it through an email. But then again, most office jobs aren't really anything that security is a big deal, I guess, really. It's not like an Adam Jensen or, you know, Fallout guy going through reading everybody's emails. Adam Jensen's from, I think that's his name, from Deus Ex, because I did that a lot too, hacking computers in that game. I think there's a new one coming out too.
Sorry about the other guys.
I don't fucking remember. There's like three of them now. So yeah, there's a lot of looting that I didn't cut out, but I cut out like 6 or 8 minutes of me looting. I forgot I kept most of the stuff in here. Not really Brotherhood of Steel, this is looting. So yeah, I'll see you guys in a few minutes, once we start getting the Brotherhood of Steel going. Once we finally turn around and get out of this computer and start talking to the guys again and start picking up some missions for them.
You better get a move on. It's not a good idea to keep Paladin Dance waiting.
No, wait a second. I forgot to loot something. Let's go see what I forgot to loot. This back corner. It's probably a bucket or a mop or something, right? Yeah. Stupid stuff. Yeah, I have a problem. I need to hoard everything. I need to loot everything. Fun fact, though, if you have Consworth as your companion, he actually dislikes you if you hoard a lot of crap. So, but luckily I got him to full lovability or whatever. But now I don't use him anymore. But he was a fun companion to tag around with. But yeah, he never liked it when I hoarded stuff. He would actually, it would pop up and say, Cornsworth, dislike that in the top corner. But obviously it doesn't really matter. But he would say some funny things. Actually, all the companions actually say some interesting things when you just loot a bunch of crap. And when you're carrying a lot of stuff, which I thought was kind of like a nice touch, because obviously Bethesda knows that its players, or at least some or most of them, like to hoard and pick up a lot of crap. So it's kind of cool that they added like stupid things like, I really don't see a use for that. That looks like junk to me. Do you need any help carrying that stuff? You know, stupid stuff like that, but I think it was nice that they've kind of put like a little effort into that. So far, I think the companions are pretty decent. They usually have some unique dialogue. But what was it? Skyrim was the last time I downloaded what was her name? I think Sophie, the companion for the PC. It was a mod. I can't remember the name of the guy who made the mod or the name of the girl who did all the voice acting for Sophia. But it was amazing. I hope that that guy and that girl like got some good jobs. Well, she's actually like a voice actress and a singer and stuff, but they did a really good job with her. Definitely just check out some videos if you can, or if you have the PC version of Skyrim, check her out if she's still up there. But she would actually have so many unique dialogues. I think it was like 400 something unique dialogues. So she would comment on everything after every quest, after like I think pretty much like all the side quests, on any of the buildings, like new areas or caves and stuff, which I think they did in the base of Skyrim, but she did in a little more detail. And she would sing for you too, funny songs and stuff, which I thought was really cool. But they still, the base game and the companions, they're not as, I don't know, not as talkative. But they're better. I think the companions overall are better in this Fallout than they have been in previous Bethesda games.
Take a look.
But yeah, basically she's just a portable bank. I don't even know if she really kills anything half the time. But yeah, sorry. This is like a big sidestep to the Brotherhood of Steel. But let's get back on track and actually talk to Dance and start this mission after I just finish up looting this crap, because I am a serious hoarder. Luckily this doesn't transfer into my real life. I'm somewhat neat and organized. But yeah, let's get back to the game.
Scribe Halen?
You better get a move on. It's not a good idea to keep Paladin Dance waiting.
Think you're some kind of hotshot?
Why are you so angry with me?
I'm not angry. I'm just letting you know where you stand. You're hired help, and that's all there is to it.
Is there any way to earn your respect?
Do what you're told. Keep your head down and your mouth shut. Now why don't you run off and see if Top needs you to do anything else?
Paladin Dance.
You ready to move out?
Why establish an outpost at the police station?
Given the nature of the facility, we felt it would be tactically advantageous to search it for weapons and ammunition. The radio tower on the roof was an unexpected boon, but it obviously has its shortcomings that need to be rectified. It might not be as imposing as the Citadel back in the capital wasteland, but it suits our purposes. That's all I'm willing to divulge at this point. Are you ready to proceed with the mission?
Ready.
Outstanding. Follow me, and try not to lag behind.
Oh yeah, just real quick, I did just want to say, that the companions in this game are talkative, but you have to, go up to them, press X, look at their face, and say, push triangle and ask for their thoughts or talk about their relationship, but they don't just do that on their own. But, yeah, Consworth is definitely the funniest, I think, with the thoughts. He usually tells some silly jokes. And then this is a problem, too. Sometimes when the AI opens the door, it kind of gets, like, stuck open or whatever, so you have to wait. But, yeah, we're just going to follow Dance and do a little dance till we get to this place. So I'll see you guys in a little bit.
We'll take this out. Follow me. Jet is a short hike to the west. If we take this road, we should be able to avoid the larger packs of ferals infesting Cambridge. Traveling this far from the police station is a risk, but getting that transmitter up and running needs to be our top priority. If it was up to me, I'd relocate my team. But Scribe Halen detected some disturbing energy readings in the area that need to be investigated. We don't know much about them, except that they're short-lived and broadcast on a frequency only attainable with a high level of technology. We're concerned that whoever or whatever is creating those energy readings might be a potential. So it's our job to investigate.
Seen better days, hasn't it?
It might surprise you to learn that my recon team isn't the first. Two other teams were sent here by the Brotherhood to gather technology. The first team's mission was a huge success. They came back with crates full of pre-war artifacts and historical documents. The second wasn't so fortunate. Shortly after they arrived, we lost contact with them, and they haven't been heard from since. As far as my team goes, we've lost four good men to this godforsaken wasteland. We've been a target from the moment we arrived. But despite our setbacks, I don't intend to give up and head home, or end up missing.
Don't mind the clutter. something.
Not yet, Pat. There it is. Arc jet systems. There shouldn't be any exterior security, so we'll head in through the front.
Alright guys, I just wanted to jump in here real quick before we hit this cutscene and end the video. We're going to talk to him, and then we're going to jump out and get our power armor that we got from the beginning of the game that I have in Sanctuary, and then we're going to jump back here with our power armor in the next video. So hit that subscribe button, and I will see you in the next Brotherhood of Steel Fallout 4 video.
Paladin.
Listen up. We do this clean and quiet. No heroics and by the book. Understood?
Why are we at ArcJet again?
We're here to retrieve a device that will boost the signal from the radio tower at the Cambridge police station. Without it, we can't make contact with our superiors. Remember, our primary target is the deep range transmitter. Stay focused and check your fire. I don't want to be hit by stray bullets.
Makes you special?